dear girls, today I am again here in front of you to take a new topic in mathematics, that is subtraction. Okay, you all are familiar with the term, but before starting we'll take a quick recap what all things are there which you should keep in your mind while doing subtraction. I'll start explaining you with the help of example. Okay, I hope everyone is sitting straight with their back straight and be attentive, girls. So suppose I am having 5 toffees with me. Okay, my dear girls, how many toffees? 5 toffees. And out of those 5 toffees, I ate 1 toffee. Is it clear? I am having 5 toffees. I have eaten 1 toffee. So how many toffees are left with me now? Or you can say, how many are remaining? Fine. So out of 5, I have taken away 1. So as you can see, I am showing it with the help of my fingers. 1, 2, 3, 4. It means 4 toffees are there with me. Now tell me what I have done. I have taken away 1 toffee out of 5 toffee. Okay. So you can say taking away is subtraction. Okay. In very simple terms, we can say whenever we take away some number, some of the things from the other one, then we are doing subtraction. Okay. Or we can say subtraction is what? Taking away. Taking away is known as subtraction. Okay. Once again, I'll give you one more example. Suppose in a box there are 3 chalks. How many chalks are there? 3 chalks. I used 1 chalk. Okay. Out of 3 chalks, I used 1 chalk. Now, how many are left with me? There are 2 chalks left with me. It means I have taken away 1. So taking away is known as subtraction. And another name for subtraction is, or you can say it is, I am doing minus. Fine. In simple terms, we say minus. Taking away is similar to minus. They are one and the same term. And this process of taking out, taking away any number of things or minus is known as subtraction. Okay. So keep in mind, my dear girls, what is subtraction? Taking away is known as subtraction. Okay. But it is very different from addition. In our last classes of addition, we learn when we add, if 2 numbers or 2 basket of things are there, and if we add the number of things present in the 2 baskets, if we add the number of things, 2 things are there, if we want to find out the total number of things, fine, the total number of things, we do addition. But when opposite to it, if we want to find out if some of the things are there, but when we take out some of the things from it, how many are left? That is called subtraction. Okay. So don't confuse addition and subtraction. They are 2 different things. They are not at all same. I hope with this term, taking away, subtraction is clear to you. And another term for it is minus. And the sign which we use for subtraction is this sign. Okay, girls? So once again I revise, subtraction means taking away, or we can say it minus, and we represent this subtraction by this sign. This is the sign which we use to represent subtraction. If this sign is there between the two numbers, it means it shows that you have to take away one number from the other. But always keep in mind, the number which you take away should either be same or less than that. It should not be more than that number. I'll tell you that with an example. Suppose, once again, I'll take an example of chalks. I have three chalks, okay? I have to use one chalk out of it. It means I am left with two chalks. Fine. Or you see here, I am having three chalks with me. I use this one. This one I used. So, how many are there? Two. Okay. So, the answer which we get, suppose three chalks were there. I used one out of it. Fine. Now, what is left? The answer is the number which is left. So, out of three chalks, one is being used. It means three chalks are there, one is being used. I am left with two chalks. So, this is the way how we are simplifying the subtraction questions in a horizontal way, from left to right. Okay? So, this is one of the way of solving subtraction. Another way is also there, using a number line. A number line, actually, girls, is a line representing the numbers from 0 to 10. I think you all have seen a scale. Everyone is having a scale in their pencil box, isn't it? So, if you look at that scale, you will find there are numbers from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, up to 6. Or if it is a bigger scale, then it has numbers till 12. So, when we draw a line representing numbers from 0 to 10, that line is named as a number line. Okay? First, we did this with the help of vertical writing, but by writing the numbers vertically, we subtracted. Another way of finding the answer in subtraction is a number line. I'll draw that number line for you. It will start with 1, 0, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and it will continue up to 10. So, this is a number line. What is the name given to this? This is your number line. Again, take one more example. Suppose there are 6. Suppose a rabbit is there on number 5, but it is hopping and it took 3 steps back. Fine. Where is the rabbit? A rabbit is there on number 5. It took 3 steps back. How? By hopping. So, this way it took 1 step, another one, second step and third step. Now, if I ask you a question, after taking 3 steps back, where is the rabbit? So, if you want to find out, you will mark these signs, you will do backward counting, and the number where you will reach is the place where the rabbit is now. Suppose the rabbit is on 5, it took 3 steps back. I brought it back. How many steps? 3 steps. So, now it is on number 2. It shows that 5, it was on 5, then it came back. Why I used? Because it is coming back. It is not moving forward. If it have moved forward, we would have added, no? But if it is coming back, but how many steps? It is coming back by 3 steps. So, this is the way we represent the backward steps in a on your number line. Fine. So, now the rabbit is on number 2. Fine. If we represent this number line here with digits, you will get answer 2. But if it is not there, with the help of number line, you can get the answer as 2. So, the same answer you will get, but there are 2 ways of finding an answer. Earlier when I showed you, with the help of fingers or by drawing lines, but in this way, number line is also one of the way of showing subtraction. Fine? I hope it is clear. Once again, I'll revise for you. What is a number line? A line representing digits from 0 to 10. Fine, my dear girls? Keep in mind, a line representing numbers from 0 to 10 is known as a number line. And it helps in finding the answer of minus, in finding the answer of subtraction. Okay? Got till here? But now, there are certain rules, there are certain facts which we need to take care while doing subtraction. The first and foremost is, whenever you are writing the numbers either horizontally, this way, or in our next class, I'll be teaching you vertical column way also. The thing to be kept in your mind is the number from which we subtract the number, another number, that number, that first number should be bigger. And then the second one should be either equal, same, or smaller. Fine? So, now after your vertical subtraction, your number line, will come to our next part of today's video, that is certain facts. For example, 5 minus 3 is equal to how many? 5 minus 3. I'll take away 3. 1, 2, 3. So how many are left with me? 2. This how I'm showing you with fingers. Okay? So the important thing which you have to take care, if you have to subtract 2 numbers, which number you will write at first place? Here, you will write the bigger number. In your earlier exercises chapter, we have read the smaller and the bigger number. Out of 5 and 3, it is very clear that 5 is bigger. So, I'll write 5 minus 3. It means from 5, I am subtracting 3 to get 2. But I cannot write the other way. Suppose I cannot say I have 3 chalks and I'll use 5 out of them. No, it's not possible, isn't it? Why? If I'm having only 3 chalks, how I'll use 5? I'll use the number only which I have. So it will be wrong. Same way, while writing the sum in vertical subtraction, in horizontal subtraction, take care the first number will be a bigger number, the next number can be smaller or equal to that. It's not necessary it's always smaller, it can be equal. I can say 5 minus 5. I can say I have 5 chalks, I have used them all. If I have 5 chalks, I have used them all, am I left with any chalk? No. I am not left with any chalk. So, my dear girls, always keep in your mind that the number from which we are subtracting is bigger. Fine? That number we'll write first. And the other number which we have to take away, that number we'll write on the second place. And if the numbers they are less than that, you can solve them with the help of fingers, by drawing lines or number lines. Fine? Now, next fact is, for every addition, suppose 5 plus 4 is equal to 9, isn't it? 5, then next I have 4, it means now I have 5 in mind, 6, 7, 8, 9. This answer we got by addition. But there is an inverse. Inverse means opposite relation between addition and subtraction. And this 9 also I can get by subtracting this 4. And if I subtract this 4, how I have done this? This is addition. Okay. Now for every addition sum, there are two subtraction facts. There are two things which we can get from the by subtracting. What are they? First, 5 plus 4 is 9. We came to know by adding them. But we can say by looking at that if we subtract this 4 from 9, fine. I have 9 fingers. If I subtract 4, I am left with 5. Yes, it is correct. I am getting the answer here. So, this is the first fact. The second is, if you keep the 9 here, now once you have shifted the 4 there, here we get 5. Now we are shifting 5 there, 9 minus 5. So what is left here? 4. Here we are showing it with a shifting of numbers, but when you actually also calculate with the help of your fingers, you will get the same answer. Suppose I have 9 chalks or toffees or something like that, and I used 5 out of them. I am left with 4. Okay? So these are the two important subtraction facts which comes out from addition. Okay? Then the third rule here is, I hope the vertical subtraction, the facts are clear. Next is few rules you need to know. Suppose, take an example, always when you subtract 0 from any number, that number can be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 or 100 or 200 or 500, 350, 450, any number. Okay, this rule is followed by all the numbers. So, it is whenever we subtract 0 from any number, always the answer is the number itself. Answer is what? The number itself. For explaining this statement, this sentence, I'll give you one example. See, suppose I have 6 toffees, but I have not eaten a single toffee. I have 6 toffees. Mere paas 6 toffees hain. But I have not eaten anything. The toffees are kept as it is. So it means I have not taken away any toffee. So I have not taken away any number of toffee. So that is, it means it is 0. Fine. You can verify your answer with your fingers or by drawing lines. Suppose I have 6 toffees. I have not eaten, I have not used any toffee, I have not taken away any toffee, I have not given any toffee from my 6 toffees. It means how many toffees are now left with me? The same number. It won't change. Okay. It shows that whenever you subtract 0 from any number, always the answer which you get here, your answer is the number itself. Fine. Take one more example. Suppose I have 5 ice creams with me, but I have kept them in a refrigerator. I'm not going to eat them. Not a single ice cream I'm going to eat. Now, if I ask you a question, tell me how many ice creams are left there with me. I have 5 ice creams. I have not eaten. I have kept them as it is. It means I have not taken away anything. If I am not taking away anything, it means I am subtracting 0. What I am minusing here? I am subtracting 0. So always the answer will be the number itself. Fine. Our second rule is, whenever you subtract 1 from any number, so you will not use every time your fingers, you will not always draw lines if you have to subtract 1. There is a rule, keep that rule in your mind. What is that rule? If we have to subtract 1 from any number, the answer which we'll get after subtracting is the number before. See how it happens. Suppose I have 6 number of anything. It can be toffees, it can be chocolates, or it can be ice creams. And I have subtracted 1. Use your 6 fingers. 6, 1. What I am getting? 5. This shows that whenever we subtract 1 from any number, the answer which we are getting is 1 less or 1 before the number. Are you getting? The answer which we get here is 1 before. What comes before 6? 1 number before 6 is 5. It shows whenever we subtract 1 from any number, the answer is 5. Now, the third rule is, whenever you subtract the same number from the number itself, okay, listen carefully once again. Whenever we subtract the same number from the number itself, always, always remember, my dear girls, your answer will be 0. How? Suppose, again take an example. I have those 6 ice creams again with me. Fine. But I have distributed. I have taken away those ice creams and I have distributed amongst 6 girls. Fine. So, I have 6 ice creams. I have distributed 6. It means 6 ice creams were there, but I have taken away. How many? 6. Will there be any ice cream left with me? No, there will be no ice cream. If there is no ice cream, my answer will be 0. So these 3 facts we need to keep in our mind while subtracting. Once again, I'll revise for you. Whenever we subtract 0 from any number, that number can be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10, 100, 500. So the answer we get in subtraction is always the same number. For example, if I have 100 number and I subtract 0 from that 100, it will remain as it is. The answer will be 100. Second rule. Whenever I subtract 1 from any number, the answer which we receive is 1 number before the, is the number before the main number. Third, whenever we subtract the number, the same number from the number itself, always our answer is 0. Fine? So, once again we'll revise what all things we studied today. We studied that what is subtraction. Okay? Taking away is known as subtraction, and it is also known as minus and represented by the sign. This is the subtraction sign. This is the sign of minus, and we can do the subtraction horizontally using fingers, using our number line. You remember a number line? A line representing numbers from 0 to 10, and that number line we can use, we can draw lines using, or we can use our fingers to do subtraction. Fine. And the rules, these all are the rules, and above all, that every addition has there is a possibility of two, in every addition sum, there is a possibility of two subtraction fact. Okay? So, that's all for today. In our next video, I'll be explaining you how to do subtraction vertically. Okay, my dear girls? Thank you.